Yes, sir, we promised you a great
match. Gorgeous, George.
Here we go. Classy, the maker of
comedy. The champ.
Rasslemania.
Rasslemania is running wild.
We're going for you,
nigga.
Coming off the heels of Survivor Series, and Survivor Series was found out who will be gunning for the WEDF Championship at the Royal Rumble, as Kofi Kingston will defend the title against the future WEDF Champion, The Miz. This is Frank Gargano alongside Drew, and guess who's back? It's Steven.
Yes, thank you, Frank Dog, and I have to say, at Survivor Series, it was great. Absolutely tremendous. DPV.
I would agree. I was able to watch that right in the commentator's booth, and what an epic night it was. We got to see Taker return and all that. And this guy right here finally going to get a shot at the WEDF title.
And I believe his time is overdue. The Miz will be challenging Kofi Kingston at the Royal Rumble for the WEDF Championship a year ago. It was deja vu. Kofi Kingston was going in the Royal Rumble as the Intercontinental Champion. Miz beat him to win the Intercontinental Championship. So will history repeat itself?
Maybe so, but this is lucky for Miz because he did beat John Morrison, or he would have been fired. So I have to say, maybe the same thing will happen, but I'm not sure at this moment yet.
I believe I'd have to give it to the Miz because he's on a roll right now. He doesn't have to worry about anyone else. It's him and Kofi. No one else. Miz saying about that how last year they were going for the Intercontinental title against each other, and fate will repeat itself.
Oh, cool.
Hold on a second. Here comes the WEDF champion, Kofi Kingston, who won that championship scramble, a little controversial ending where the steering contest and him and The Rock. Kofi just hit a trouble in paradise. I don't know if The Rock expected that, but anyway, Kofi remains the WEDF champion just barely, though. Because Kingston was the interim champion with like 30 seconds left.
He said it was almost won by Batista, but Kofi, he pulled it out. Nearly a split second with I don't know how long to go, but it was very, very close.
I mean, since Miz beat Kofi, and Miz hasn't been able to beat Kofi. Remember, at Triple Threat at Bragging Rights, Kofi beat Miz and Morrison in Triple Threat.
What? Here comes the man who almost won it.
Here comes the animal. Batista. What do you think was going through Batista's mind right now as he comes out here?
He's the animal. He's pissed off.
He's probably really mad. He's probably really, really mad.
Comes out here. He's probably going to want a shot of his own or something. I mean, if Kofi wasn't able to get Rock alone away from everyone else, then Batista would be standing in Kofi's spot right now.
He's just saying he was screwed.
Whoa, and Drew, you're right. He's asking for another shot at the title.
It's on.
Kofi, the brash little guy he is, he's going to accept the challenge.
And Batista, I don't know how promising he will see the Miz at the Royal Rumble.
Wow, so it might be the Miz versus Batista at the Royal Rumble.
And if
then
I
again,
was...
then again, Kofi could be going to the Royal Rumble.
If I was the Miz, I'd watch the match carefully, let the two destroy themselves as much as they can, and pick apart the pieces, I guess.
Terrible.
Here comes Booker T. He was robbed indeed at Survivor Series of MVP 1 via countout to retain the United States Championship.
It's been... And Booker is every... These title shots he's getting, that triple threat against Jericho and MVP, oh, and last night at Survivor Series, he's just been screwed over.
And Booker T's getting another shot. Time. This time it's no countout. So up next, Booker T will challenge yet again for the United States Championship against MVP, this time in the no countout match. MVP cannot get himself counted out. This is no countout, so will MVP retain?
I don't know. He didn't count it out this time, so it's going to be a fair, great match.
Yeah, one escape route he can't take. He has to fight Booker straight up. He can't run from his battles. He has to learn to fight them.
I have something to say. What about Randy Orton?
Yeah, look who helped him there. That was Brock Lesnar. Two times that MVP beat Randy Orton a few weeks ago. Once for the United States title and once to defend it. Both times Brock Lesnar interfered and helped MVP win.
So it just looks like MVP just... He's been stealing wins here. Stealing wins to retain his title at any cost, basically. Will his luck run out tonight?
That's the question I was about to answer. Now, there's no count out. He can't run. It's time to face his dues. Real question I've got going in my head. Will Randy Orton get involved?
I don't think Orton
doesn't give a damn about the United States title. He beat Lesnar. He's done with that. He wants to move on to bigger and better things.
Anyway, here comes Booker T. What do you think is going through Booker T's mind since he got this rematch here tonight?
I say Booker T is now very confident now. He gets a second chance at the United States Championship, and... I think he's gonna pick up the win. I'm not sure though.
Booker T is quite experienced in the ring. It's been well over 20 years since he started in this business. MVP, he's gonna have to find a way to actually beat him tonight.
Booker T getting another shot. This is gonna be a great match here.
Here we go, this match is underway between Booker T and MVP. Booker T himself, a former United States champion, won at the King of the Ring at the end against Kofi Kingston to win the King of the Ring title, which Batista, ironically enough, interfered. You know, that's what started the whole Batista-Kofi rivalry.
Batista and Kofi have been at each other's necks for a little while now, and tonight we'll get to see it come full on.
Here we go, this match is underway. What's the strategy now for these competitors as MVP goes from behind? With the front face lock.
These two are more technical wrestlers, I'd say, especially Booker's age, and just MVP himself is technically sound, I guess you could say, but they have to win the technical battle to win the match.
Now Booker, MVP with a kick to the gut.
MVP now takes control. Ooh, nice elbow to the back of the head.
He's gonna start brawling, start fighting.
MVP with those right hands now whipping Booker.
Stop. Oh! That's hilarious.
Booker T is actually stopping his tracks and called MVP off guard with a clothesline. Now Booker whipping MVP. MVP with a kick to the gut. MVP wanting nothing. Booker, remember, this is no countout. So he can't get himself counted out, retained. He'll get Booker counted out.
Can't do it, MVP. You have to fight. You have to wrestle this man.
It's no running away now.
Booker, that's actually really good for him. He can do damage on the outside much more than just the regular mat in the ring.
Fine, no!
Oh! Wow!
DDT by MVP.
That was pretty good. Pretty good counter. Booker T comes back.
MVP countering into an armbar. You don't really see MVP and Booker going for wrestling moves. You do see them going for fist fights. This is kind of awkward to see this happen because both are really brawlers. Oh, there's, speaking of brawls, there's a clothesline there by Booker T exploding.
Oh, Booker T's gonna do the chops now. He's getting MVP in that corner.
But no. MVP now coming back. And whoa, no one moved.
He blocked the boot.
That Booker T, the veteran, countering that big boot. Well, that translated into some momentum.
Booker, I think it is.
Oh,
what's this?
Booker gonna do in. Oh, nice fisherman suplex by Booker T.
Booker now into the cover.
Guess not.
From the Miz, not from his MVP.
Booker blocked another kick by MVP.
Booker T just taking control. He knows every move MVP will pull out of him.
MVP, nope. Another kick. Booker T also. Oh, Booker met him with a kick.
Nice heel by Booker T.
The flexibility of Booker T at age like 45, I believe, is just amazing for a man his age.
Really is. Those legs, they've always served.
Never know what plan. Booker T.
Going for the cover. No. I didn't mean one count.
You never know what Booker T can do at any moment.
Booker T, he is.
Oh, that's coming connect.
He does not block the boot this time.
What's so MVP that's the hit. MVP now taking control after that kick to the face, boot to the face, but no!
Ooh,
MVP gets... Oh! What a counter by MVP sending Booker to the outside. Now MVP has control.
MVP, he is starting to wear down Booker, but Booker...
Oh, catches him with an upside kick. Right in the face.
MVP had control, but Booker just shut it down with that kick.
Like I said, Booker T's probably very confident in this match.
Now Booker, what's another sidekick. Booker T could be moments away from winning the United States Championship right now. We got to cover. One, two. Oh, MVP kicks out.
MVP just getting the shoulder up. MVP,
he's running again. He's...
Oh, what?
Whoa, he's...
Wait, he's going to...
Chair.
I think he's trying to take another cheap way out.
This is no... This disqualifications are still on, so he could just get it.
Wait, MVP!
Oh, MVP got stabbed! Oh my god! Really?
Again, MVP... He... MVP. Like a damn coward, he uses a cheap way to retain his title.
Wait a minute!
Booker T not happy about that!
Booker's had enough of MVP's bullcrap.
Sending MVP in the ring, making MVP pay. MVP took another cheap way out. And Booker's gonna...
Wait a minute, here he comes!
Oh.
Here he comes!
Scissor kick!
Scissor kick by Booker T.
Oh, this thing is far over. Booker T did not want to lose like this. I mean, he won via disqualification, but he wanted to win that title in the ring.
Rocking on, not MVP.
He's still United States champion, but he's on his face on the mat.
Finally got rid of Armando Estrada.
Now, of course, this is going to be gunning for that United States Championship. It's going to be a four-man battle royal. A little preview for the Royal Rumble.
Ooh, this is very interesting.
Here comes
Kane.
One half of the WEDF Tag Team Champions.
And they picked up a win at Survivor Series, beating DX.
They will get, DX has requested another match with Kane and Big Show, though. And if DX wins, they'll be facing Kane and Big Show again for those tag team titles at the Royal Rumble. So a lot at stake in this match for the champions and the challengers.
The question is, can DX beat Big Show and Kane?
They haven't been able to on the past few chances ever since after Bragging Rights, so my answer to that question is, I don't know. I don't think they can.
I really don't know who can stop these two monsters. I mean, they've been dominating ever since they got the tag team title.
And Big Show, he is not only one half the WEDF tag team champion, he's also the television champion.
Speaking of the Big Show, he will be on ECCW defending that television championship in a six-man over the top rope battle royal.
I don't know how someone can get this guy over the ropes. It's gotta be hell.
Because over the top rope, how are you gonna get the Big Show over the top rope at the Royal Rumble? I mean, that's...
People have to focus him. They have to work together to get the biggest man out of the ring.
I mean, you saw him happen in 2004. He shoved like 8 men away.
Here comes DX.
I am sure that Triple H still remember, and HBK remember what Big Show and Kane, how they attacked HBK a few weeks ago.
They remember that they were just taking out their anger on DX.
Here they come.
This is DX. DX is the last chance. They don't get this win. I basically don't know what the future is for them. They have to pick up the win in order to get another shot at the tag team championship.
That's correct.
It is DX's time. They need to be ready tonight. They need to forget about their losses. And knowing how experienced these two are, HBK and Triple H, they're veterans in this business. They know what they must do. But Big Show and Kane, they're not exactly younglings themselves.
Speaking of DX, it's now or never if they want to get a shot at those tag team titles. And if they do win tonight, that would lead to some momentum. But if they lose, that's it. They don't get another shot.
If they lose, what can DX do?
Here we go. The referee rings the bell. Shawn Michaels and Kane to start it off. Shawn Michaels already started off with an atomic drop kick to Kane.
The chop.
United a few
already.
On United, the past United, Kane beat Shawn Michaels.
But they need. But
so in single action, Kane and Big Show have had DX's number as well. I mean, Triple H beat Kane via count at one time, but Kane pretty much dominated Triple H.
Kane just did it to mess with the head of Triple H, and recently in the losses that we've seen, it's just been getting to them. DX has really found their match in Big Show and Kane.
You know, Mike, the only one with knife edge chops on Kane.
Tonight, DX needs to forget about everything that's happened. SG Joe there by Shawn Michaels. They need to win. But how do they do it, really?
So Shawn Michaels trying to ground Kane, but Kane having none of it.
Kane is just trying to fight. Well, HBK's trying to fight more, but Kane, he can just easily dominate Michaels in any way he wants.
What is the strategy here for Shawn Michaels, who's the smaller man in this match?
He needs to, well, considering that I guess Kane is a little bit smaller than Big Show in terms of weight or height, he needs to focus on the legs of both Big Show and Kane.
From DX, I want to single out the smaller man, Kane. I mean, you don't want to get in the ring with Big Show, who would be fresh. That would be a huge mistake on DX's part, and Triple H with the kick to stink. Look for those knees.
Also, if you work on the legs and arms of Kane, then he loses that devastating chokeslam that has really been proving to be hell for DX. There we go. Oh, Triple H working on the legs like I'm saying. And now the arm. Very smart strategy.
Very smart strategy indeed. They're actually using some strategy instead of going power for power. Triple H is a power guy, but now that, speaking of power, that he went for a mistake there. Trying to go for a suplex. Oh, wait, Triple H.
Oh, Triple H. Wow.
He knocked Big Show off. That's smart.
Triple H now taking control.
Hey,
here comes Shawn Michaels. Looks like they're trying to work on that ultra pain. You look at that arm that takes away the chokeslam.
You guys did work on the
Shawn Michaels, oh!
Very nice sidekick. Like you said, Frank, they are working on the smaller man, trying to wear him down.
And they're grounding him too. Don't call Kane a small man. He's just a smaller man than the Big Show. Plain and simple.
Oh! DX has gotten the upper hand of.
I see what DX is doing. They're just keeping Kane in the corner, not giving Big Show a chance to tag in Kane.
Or Kane to tag in Big Show, you mean?
And my bad.
No worries. Anyways,
Triple H again working on Kane. Kane's in big trouble. He's in need of a big tag, but DX keeps making these quick tags to keep each other fresh.
Ooh. Smart strategy there. I mean, Kane, he's barely been able to get out of the gate. He put up some offense early, but ever since Michael Triple H has been fast tagging, it's just Kane hasn't gotten much out of it.
Shawn Michaels from behind. Oh, look at this. Shawn Michaels, a back super by Kane.
That is some strength.
Now a tag to Triple H. Oh, Kane made Triple H.
Oh!
Maybe a desperation by Kane.
Oh,
now tags in the Big Show. And
Big Show's here, and this is not who you want. You'd rather face Kane, and rather facing Kane sounds hell enough, but Big Show is... He's bigger
too.
Than Kane. And fresh.
And, oh,
Big Show, what?
Oh!
God.
450-pound splash, and now Big Show with a shoulder tackle. That's caught by the world's largest athlete.
Big Show is taking full control, and oh!
They can steal it. Slap across your chest, that's what that feels like. Oh, Triple H is trying to fight back.
Triple H back now.
He's fighting.
Kick to the gut, but oh!
Big Show. And
oh, wait.
Certainly grabs the ref, but
he's distracting the ref! Now Kane!
What's he gonna do? Oh!
I'm surprised that didn't result in a disqualification or referee using his five count. Kane and Big Show taking advantage.
Now that one-handed spine buster.
Here's a cover.
One, two.
Oh. Now Michael's there to break it up.
Ooh. But the tag team, the double team on that corner is what really gave them the opening. But Triple H again trying to fight back with some right hands, runs off the ropes. Oh,
big boot. Oh!
Oh, the
boot. Hit him with a big boot.
Spoke too soon right there.
Triple H needs to get a tag, but I don't know how much Shawn Michaels can really do. Show.
Scoop.
My God!
That's 500 pounds nearly going across.
Triple H coming back.
Oh, wow. A thumb poke to the eyes. What the? Why?
Ooh. Big Show. And oh,
boot.
Big
Show
dominating. Stomping.
Triple H. Keeping them down. Big Show. And oh!
Shawn Michaels.
Well, payback.
Bad idea.
Triple H recovers.
He dodges.
Triple H.
Oh, Big Show.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
He got Big Show up somehow.
Shawn Michaels now in.
Shawn Michaels.
Out of knife chop. He kicks. Shawn Michaels went.
Oh, from the belly to belly. Here comes Kane.
Kane back in, and he's recovered now. This could spell trouble for Shawn Michaels. We got the first tag.
Shawn Michaels needs to pull out a... Oh!
Speaking of pulling out, he pulls right out. Just like that, the flying forearm. Classic Shawn Michaels. Now here we go.
Vintage HBK right here.
And a scoop slam.
Oh!
You've seen this before. Wait a minute.
Oh.
He's just set up. Kane. Oh!
Oh!
Just like that, Kane just shifted the momentum.
Shawn Michaels had a little going there, but Kane has it. Of it.
Looks like Kane going up high.
Going high risk! Oh!
Oh! Oh. Well, just like at Survivor Series, he blocked it.
I think went for sweet chin music. Oh! Kane overpowering Shawn Michaels again. This time, no sweet chin music.
Ooh, drop kick.
Shawn Michaels. Shawn Michaels, what is he?
Going up high. Kane in trouble. Big kick. Missile drop kick on the outside.
Shawn Michaels getting hyped on that missile drop kick.
Shawn Michaels, he's starting to really get ahead of Kane.
Michaels in. Oh, the drop. And another
drop. What's he gonna do?
The rope. And
DDT.
Oh, and he and Kane.
It open. Shawn Michaels.
On
five four.
Vintage elbow drop from Shawn Michaels.
Hey, and here comes Triple H.
Want to pick up the scraps on the Kane. Here we go. Double Ice Spine Buster.
Here it is. Triple H all fired up.
And DX, they might be able to pull this one off.
Here it comes.
Can he hit? Last time Kane got out of it. Well, this time. Well, what? It
won't kick out.
That's it. And there goes the Big Show.
Off smart. Cover him.
We got to cover. Will this be it? One. Two.
Three.
DX will yet again challenge Kane and Big Show at the Royal Rumble for the WEDF Tag Team Championship. What an effort by DX.
That was
finally beat Kane and Big Show.
That was very smart by DX. It worked on Kane. Big Show got tagged in for a bit, but it was rather than to let Kane back in, who DX had already previously worn down, and they picked apart the pieces and were able to pull out the win.
And Triple H topped it off the pedigree right here.
When Kane kicked up after getting busted open at Survivor Series, but this time he did not, and DX just stayed on the whole match, and thus they earned another shot at the tag team titles. Will they walk out the tag team champions at the Royal Rumble though? We'll have to find out.
They keep
DX win. I believe they will be 4-time tag team champions.
That DX has to use the same strategy at the Royal Rumble in order to get the double. I would have to say.
But will Kane and Big Show, will they be smarter next time to rather than let Kane take all the punishment?
Up next, after a commercial break, the number one contenders match for the United States Championship and an over-the-top rope challenge. Who will challenge MVP at the Royal Rumble for the U.S. title? We'll find out next after this promo for the Royal Rumble.
The Royal Rumble match. 40 superstars. One winner. The prize? A main event championship opportunity at WrestleMania. One winner. A who's who of WWE superstars.
Wait a minute!
What makes this match so special? Let's count the ways.
6. The Deadman, The Undertaker, the record for the number of victims eliminated by the feared Deadman in a single Rumble match under the WEDF banner. The Phenom also holds the most time for being in a Rumble event, at 18 minutes, 27 seconds. The Straight Edge Society leader CM Punk on the underhand wasn't as fortunate as the Deadman, as he was only being in the Rumble at 52 seconds, the shortest time for any competitor being in the Rumble. This year, will anyone break that dubious record? This is first year a Rumble event took place. Danny Jackpot came out the victor, as he won the first ever Rumble match in WEDF history. Will history repeat itself? Which number brings the most of fortunes? That would be the number 27. Four men have won the Royal Rumble via the 27th selection. Tonight, will that number once again lead to success?
3. Stone Cold reigns in Royal Rumble match wins with 3 grueling victories. And with an unprecedented 40 WWE superstars making this the biggest Royal Rumble match in history, the numbers mean more than ever, both the highs and the lows. Number 1, a definite disadvantage, where time is not on your side. Yet a number that has produced the same amount of winners as the number 30 spot.
John Cena has won the Royal Rumble in a huge shocker!
This year, there will be 40 superstars, but there can only be one. Who will prevail to earn a shot to headline Rasslemania?
I was never the kind to be taking my time in a place that's worth a damn.
There's only one road to WrestleMania, and it begins at the Royal Rumble.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen, the Royal Rumble will be here, I believe, hopefully, August the 18th. And here comes the Celtic Warrior, Sheamus, who is yet to be confirmed for the Royal Rumble match. But he's going to be competing in this match to determine the number one contender for the United States Championship in this match is going to be an over-the-top Rumble Battle Royal. Will it stage of what's to come at the Royal Rumble?
So, it's proof.
Okay.
Sheamus, he's been making an impact here on Raw, like, ever since he left ECCW.
Making Samoa Joe a target.
Oh, Joe now.
Oh, Joe, he's been kind of, I don't know what's been going on with him, but he hasn't really gotten anywhere in WWE recently, and this because is his chance to really
Sheamus
step up.
Been blindsiding him. It all started when Sheamus attacked Samoa Joe before Samoa Joe took on Suspect, and Suspect left the SmackDown on right turn. Sheamus has given Samoa Joe a living hell. Sheamus literally has called Samoa Joe a joke. He just says he's not the man that he's claimed to be. Oh, wait a second here. Look who's returned.
It's JBL.
The Wrestling God. JBL. Everyone give a round of applause.
I haven't seen this man since The Miz beat him.
Well, I don't think anyone has seen him since the Great American Brawl, I believe, when Suspect beat JBL. When Suspect beat JBL in the Raw after that, I don't think we've seen JBL in a few months. I mean, but what a way to return here, as JBL is confirmed for the Royal Rumble match.
JBL could be on his way to the United States Championship match at the Royal Rumble, but he has to go through in order.
Uh-oh, here we go. Matt Eichhorn, a man on the mission.
The man that put Estrada away.
And now he can focus on what he's wanting to pursue, that being the United States Championship. Now he's proved everyone wrong, the critics and everyone. Now he's steamrolled through a lot of the Raw roster. But he's hung with the big boy. This is a big test for Matt Eichhorn, though. And he's competing in this over-the-top rope battle royal where anything can go.
Anything could go, indeed. Matt Eichhorn can maybe pick up the win. You never know. You have to go, like I said, you have to go through three other men, just like the rest of these other men. And all these men, I would have to say, are brawlers. Big-time brawlers.
Right in this match, I'd have to personally give it to Eichhorn for the role he's been on. Finally getting rid of Estrada. Finally not having to worry about anyone attacking him from the back. He gets to be his own man.
Yeah, whoa, look at that. JBL could be gone already. Ooh, Samoa Joe taking control.
Oh.
And,
you know, so Samoa Joe and Sheamus are going at each other. Samoa Joe's been wanting to get his hands on Sheamus. He blames Sheamus for not facing a man up. Sheamus has got to face a man up here now.
This is Joe's chance to get a little revenge. I wouldn't necessarily let him so quick. Maybe beat up Sheamus a little bit and then get rid of him.
Samoa Joe and Sheamus do have a personal conflict going on with them. Get it over with right now.
And Eichhorn, he's... Oh, Samoa Joe and,
What is strategy in this matchup? Here, oh, JBL about got eliminated.
Oh, very close. The strategy is... Well, obviously, the biggest man in this match is Sheamus. Well, not in terms of weight.
In terms of weight, Eichhorn's got... is the biggest man. All of these men are big, though. They're... No small man.
Yeah, but honestly, I give Sheamus the power advantage out of all these guys. I would. So if you can get rid of him, then you don't have to worry about that rogue kick.
Oh, look at this!
Sheamus, oh my.
Joe and Eichhorn are going at each other right now.
Both Sheamus. Biggest men in this battle royal.
Oh,
Eichhorn just taking it to spine buster.
Joe follows what the Bulldog is, every man for himself, basically. That's what Joe proved.
JBL.
It's a kick. Ooh.
Eichhorn got both Sheamus and Samoa Joe.
And then, close. It's like what happened to JBL a few moments ago, but
Eichhorn hanging on.
Eichhorn will hang on. Ooh! DDT by Samoa Joe onto JBL. JBL hasn't been able to do
JBL's getting triple teamed here.
Wow.
JBL's in big trouble.
This is his night back too. This is not looking good at all for JBL.
I mean, the man with the most experience, there goes JBL. Who's going to win this over the top row battle road to win the United States Championship at the Royal Rumble? We'll find out when we return from this commercial break. Wasn't going nowhere, running. Ladies and gentlemen, we're back to Raw in this over the top rope battle royal. You can see Sheamus is in trouble. Sheamus, oh, there he goes. Eliminated by both Matt Eichhorn and Samoa Joe. We're down to two. We about missed that. Sheamus during the commercial break was actually busted wide open.
Sheamus got face busted by Eichhorn. Busted Sheamus open. Now it comes down to the two biggest men in this battle royal.
Sheamus and Samoa Joe is kind of clever how Samoa Joe actually got rid of Sheamus after what Sheamus gave Samoa Joe for the past few weeks. Now it's down to these two, possibly the most similar two men on the
Samoa
roster.
Joe!
Oh!
Very close, but Samoa Joe able to hang on, and Eichhorn, ooh.
Sheamus, Samoa Joe in trouble.
Oh, will Joe hang on and...
And
very, he survives for now.
Samoa Joe coming back.
Samoa Joe's...
Samoa Joe misses there.
Samoa Joe, he wants to do it to Eichhorn and...
Wow!
Joe hangs on, barely.
Eichhorn was able to duck that and... send.
And
that spinning heel kick.
Spinning heel kick by Samoa Joe. One of these men are going...
Eichhorn, he keeps ducking these.
One of these men are going to face MVP at the Royal Rumble, but the real question is, who will it be?
You see Samoa Joe in trouble. Samoa Joe, will he hang on again? Will he? Yes, he does.
Samoa Joe, he's getting very close to not being able to hang on.
What a kick.
The face.
Styles are real similar to each other. Samoa Joe might be a little more... Oh, what a clothesline. A little more quicker between the two. But Eichhorn might be more powerful, I think.
That could come to show here in this match.
Oh wait, Eichhorn!
Oh, there goes Samoa Joe!
Just like that, yeah. Eichhorn will be challenging MVP at the Royal Rumble for the United States Championship.
Here's some of the replays. That's how James got busted open.
That was during our commercial break. And then Eichhorn at the end managed to overpower Samoa Joe and win and to capture the United States Championship shot. So Eichhorn gets what he's been pursuing.
Estrada anymore to set up any roadblocks. It's just straight to that title from here.
We're going to be looking United States champion, maybe.
Eichhorn to capture.
And now MVP has to worry because
MVP be warned.
Whoa. Chris Jericho.
Jericho's like, what's going on here?
Kane and Big Show argue about their loss.
Now they're talking about the deal with him again.
Oh! Big Show threatening Kane. Ooh. Anyway, up next, a big triple threat need for momentum between three confirmed participants for the Royal Rumble. Jericho, CM Punk, John Morrison. Who will win against the momentum? We'll find out up next. And here's The Rock, who will be facing Brock Lesnar later on tonight in the SummerSlam 2002 rematch.
Here comes our savior.
CM Punk, he lost against Stone Cold at Survivor Series. But, he's got something else to focus on now. Maybe he doesn't have to deal with Stone Cold anymore. He just found out that he just can't control a Texas Rattlesnake, no matter what. Anyway, CM Punk might have a chance to win the Royal Rumble, though. He might gain something bigger.
Yes, maybe. Maybe CM Punk will meet Austin in the Rumble.
Not only that, CM Punk might win the Rumble. He's already declared himself a favorite.
CM Punk is indeed on a mission. But here comes Chris Jericho.
Jericho, he's never won a Rumble. All three of these men have never won a Royal Rumble. August 18th might be their chance.
All three men looking to win the Royal Rumble.
They really got their eyes on the Royal Rumble. They need to think about this match tonight to get the momentum from building up.
Yeah, one of these men will, I have to say, whoever picks up the win, like you said, Drew, they will gain some momentum heading into the Royal Rumble.
All three of the men are former world champions in WEDF. And winning that Rumble would guarantee you a championship shot. Unless you were screwed out like Danny Jackpot was in last year's Royal Rumble. Let's hope that doesn't happen again this year. And here comes the former two-time WEDF champion, John Morrison, who I think might be a big favorite going into the Royal Rumble, considering the year John Morrison has had. What a year that would conclude if he added a Royal Rumble win to his resume.
John Morrison.
I mean, he's won Money in the Bank. No one has won a Money in the Bank, a Royal Rumble, a WEDF Championship, become a Grand Slam champion in all in the same year. Never, no one has ever done that before.
And it is Morrison's chance to find, to be the one to claim that. And I couldn't give it to anyone else, really. Morrison has proved himself this year to be one of the top dogs on Raw and in WEDF overall.
Morrison, WEDF champion.
Here we go. This is in the way. What do you do in a triple threat like this? What is the strategy?
Well, you do what Chris Jericho does. He lets two guys work on each other, and he steals a win. That I gotta give this match to Chris Jericho, because he's a master at doing what he does. He knows what to do. He knows how to watch for weakness. He knows when to slip out and let the other two fight it, and then just come out of nowhere and win it for himself.
That's how John Morrison's fighting off both CM Punk and Jericho, trying to double-team the former WEDF champion John Morrison.
It's not looking good for John Morris now.
Oh! Just don't last long.
Oh, look at this!
John Morrison, oh! And oh!
Morrison Jericho!
Jericho gets flashed.
The lights sweep by Morrison. Now here comes Chris Jericho.
That's
Chris Jericho
like
now comes back.
Oh, like Rumble, you gotta have eyes on the back of your head. It's a little tester.
Yeah, and
Punk, and
nice power slam going for a cover.
Whoa, he's trying to pick up the win.
Have a slow delay, and Punk might have been able to win that. Nice punch.
Punk, gonna do it. Hip toss.
Oh, look out, Punk! That flash kick! And Morrison now! Going after Punk!
Punk, eyes in the back of his head.
Look at this, Punk. Now going after Morrison.
Morrison quickly dodged Asti and Punk. That's the quickness John Morrison possesses. He has a lot of quickness.
What's Punk gonna do here?
And Punk! Nice neck break. These are like the Moonlight Drive, which John Morrison does. That looks like a Moonlight Drive almost.
Open-handed slap by CM Punk.
Chris Jericho, nice little suplex right there. John Morrison!
Morrison again with a flash kick. We got a cover. And Punk there, just there to break it up.
Punk and they need to watch John Morrison. He keeps throwing out those flash kicks, and it's not going to be helpful late in the match, and that snap suplex.
And Chris Jericho, but no, John Morrison,
like
Chris
a
Jericho,
Jericho springboarding, Punk, is his left side,
and Sam Punk's just kicking everybody, Oh, and there goes CM Punk.
Uh-oh, Jericho gonna take it for a ride. Change of what happens at the Royal Rumble? If Morrison was in the last three, he would have won the Royal Rumble that way.
What's Morrison doing?
I don't think, like I said, if Morrison did that, he would have won the Royal Rumble. If it was the final three, if these two were the final three.
Chris Jericho. Ooh. Went into announce table right there. John Morrison just staying back.
Ooh.
Look at Morrison!
Push John Morrison!
Oh! He catches.
John Morrison going up high. And ooh.
Very nice.
What a kick. And oh! Meaning CM Punk with the kick now.
Ooh.
Next. Who's going to win this triple threat match and gain some momentum heading into Royal Rumble? We're going to have to take another commercial break. We'll find out when we return. Oh, oh, wow.
Dan Hardy, what a song.
Incredible.
Ladies and gentlemen, we welcome you back to Raw. John Morrison almost won off that roll-up. What a hellacious triple threat this has been so far. CM Punk actually hit a GTS during the commercial break. Look at the roll-up tipped up. One, two.
Ooh.
Oh, wait. Counter.
Wait.
One.
Oh.
I was Punk went for GTS to hit on Jericho, but Morrison hit a DDT and tried to almost win the match against CM Punk. We almost missed the outcome of this match. Morrison thinking it's wrapped. Now look at Jericho going for the walls.
There go walls.
Walls.
Walls of Jericho. Can you get it locked in?
Settling it out like crazy. Oh. The commercial right now. We're going to find out who's going to win this match and gain a lot of momentum. Jericho's got the walls locked in. Well, no. Punk, that break it up. And what a kick to Jericho. And
now, another kick.
And those kicks.
And a counter by.
Nice.
Locked in. Morrison's in trouble.
Morrison could tap out. Oh.
Morrison is in submission hold right there. Who's going to win this? Oh, great. Drop kick.
Beautiful drop kick. And Chris Jericho. This is vintage Jericho right here.
The Bulldog.
Very nice by Chris Jericho.
Morrison!
Morrison!
Ah, that could knock Chris Jericho out, but too close to the ropes.
Morrison should have dragged him. If Morrison dragged him in the center of the ring, Morrison might have had that match won. Jericho now recovered that bit.
Jericho, I think he was looking for the walls, but Morrison counters.
Jericho's a little woozy there, but
Jericho with an arm. Look at Punk! Punk from behind, German suplex! Jericho never saw it coming. Now Punk may be looking to pick up the scraps on John Morrison. No Morrison,
roll it! Roll up!
We got a roll up!
This could be it! One!
Two!
Two.
No!
No, wait!
Reverse! Two! No!
Whoa!
So many near falls in this match! Who's got the guts to win this match? So many near falls in.
Ooh, he's on the arm of CM Punk.
Takes.
Okay.
So what strength they had. They had.
Morrison in trouble. Jericho. Look at Jericho. Trimmer is a gurry.
Oh!
Morrison!
And good night.
This could be Jericho's chance.
Jericho needs to two slaps missed. There you go. Here he hits one. It's another.
Wait, Chris Jericho. Chris Jericho. Oh, wait, wait, wait.
Hold up.
One.
Two.
No.
Oh, versus. Very close, Jericho. No.
Versus one.
No.
Like, and then Jericho's rolling him over. Can he walk? He's got the walls of Jericho locked in.
The wall.
He actually goes to the road control the walls of Jericho.
That's Morrison's getting in the ring and. Oh.
Morrison, this is the match. Punk looks like he was about to tap out there.
Yeah, Morrison saved it. Ooh!
And the Punk.
And Bench hit Punk. Hold on.
Punk got
screwed.
Yeah. Well, this game won.
One, two,
wow, that's
it.
Morrison, I don't think, was able to break it up. Jericho just barely kicked out.
Morrison going after CM Punk. CM Punk over the rope.
There goes CM Punk. What is Morrison going to do here?
A minute. I think Morrison.
Morrison about to get started. Pain.
Ooh. Ooh, punishing the back of Chris
Morrison.
Jericho.
What's this?
And like,
is he?
Oh, Dark Japan!
Like a Punk! Punk!
Here it is!
In the ring!
Hey, Punk! Wait a minute!
God.
GTS!
GTS!
It's it! It's it! Punk to steal it!
This match won!
We gotta come from
steal it!
One, two, three! And yes, our saver CM Punk has won this match!
What a victory for CM Punk, and now CM Punk has a lot of momentum now. Coming up on loss to Stone Cold, he's won this match in this triple threat tonight. And what a win it was for CM Punk.
S taking advantage, and then CM Punk got the 1-2-3, picking up the win.
Austin was smart to knock out CM Punk, and he tried to... He hit the Starship Pain on Jericho and he almost picked up the win, but Punk came in and was able to steal one.
What a way to CM Punk.
I thought like Chris Jericho had this match, but CM Punk just taking advantage of some points in the match.
CM Punk saying, go to sleep John Morrison, and he did.
And here's Brock Lesnar, who's got a huge match against The Rock up next. This is a SummerSlam 2002 rematch. These two are going to be in the Royal Rumble match as well. Momentum is on the line. Who's going to win this huge match? We're going to find out next. Fans are about to be electrified. Here comes the People's Champion, The Rock.
Because we've all not heard enough about the People's Champ, The Rock, and blah, blah, blah.
People's Champion, almost. Like, he did very well in the Scramble match.
I mean, he had several rock bottoms during that match. Maybe a little too much. I mean, Rock was the interim champion a few times in that match, but just couldn't get the job done. He became a three-time WEDF champion.
Definitely
he had another chance at the Royal Rumble, but he'd have to throw 39 others over the top rope.
Can Rock do it? He actually, last year's Royal Rumble, I believe, he was the last elimination from Danny's jackpot win.
Yes, Rock came close last year. Will he win it this year?
There comes Brock Lesnar. And
these superstars are former Royal Rumble winners.
I have to say, Brock Lesnar might not be in a good mood.
He just came up a loss to the Randy Orton at Survivor Series just 5 days ago.
Randy Orton picked up the win.
Oh, Lesnar, he gets to take out some anger on The Rock tonight.
Brock Lesnar, he was saying how Randy Orton never beat him, and he did. An RKO from nowhere, I have to say. And now we have the biggest man here in WEDF. Rocking up. Rock.
Rock.
No. Brock Lesnar. No. The Rock.
Starting off with a lot of reversals to start this match.
And The Rock.
Ooh. Missing it barely.
Well, Brock Lesnar now coming back.
Lesnar starting to really hit those punches and a kick.
And ooh. Jeez. That big right hand from Brock Lesnar can do some damage. And ooh.
Ooh. Shoulder tackle by The Rock.
Here's an early cover. Nothing from The Rock.
Can't put down a man like Brock Lesnar that easy.
And The Rock just throwing right hands. And ooh!
Sends him over the rope, just like what he's got to do at the Royal Rumble.
Yeah, it's a sending hand over the top rope. Both feet hitting the floor. And ooh. We go now back in the ring.
The Rock is... He's got to get pumped up here, but Lesnar, he's too much to handle, I'd personally say, after what happened at Survivor Series. Lesnar will want to kick ass, and he gets The Rock tonight.
Yeah, Lesnar, I have to say, I could feel his anger. I could sense his anger.
Oh, Rock. I think Lesnar...
Wait, The Rock's setting up.
Oh.
Rock Lesnar hightailing it out of there.
That was smart strategy. The Rock, I think he wanted to do a rock bottom or something big there, but Lesnar was smart and got out of the ring, and back suplex by Lesnar.
That's what I was saying. I could feel the anger of Lesnar coming off a loss in Survivor Series. Now, he's just going to, like you said, Drew, he's just going to take all his anger out of The Rock.
Right now, it looks like he's doing that very well. Lesnar's been in control of this so far. No, but Rock's starting to fight back, and he's gonna... Rock's gonna do, and...
Rock, no.
Oh,
clothesline.
Very nice. Could take your head off there. Lesnar.
Lesnar now.
And then that car... Oh!
Dude, just shoulder thrust right into the gut of The Rock.
Rock has got to be feeling the pain right here.
Rock now coming back.
Oh, The Rock.
Wait a minute.
Ooh, vintage Rock.
Whoa! Big time. Who's on better Rock?
The Rock gonna do. I think he's... Suplex. Ooh! Very nice, throw the suplex in the cover immediately. One, two.
Brock Lesnar getting the shoulder up. Then The Rock, and ooh, working on the knee of Lesnar right now. What would have to be the strategy in this match for The Rock?
The Rock, he needs to not take on the power game. The power game of Lesnar is much too big to handle, but... I mean, The Rock himself, he is no small man. He can take on Lesnar. He just needs to make sure he doesn't get caught in a power struggle.
Ooh, we just saw that vintage spine bust by The Rock. Here's the cover. One, two, and three.
Rock. Headlock. No. Lesnar coming back.
Coming back. Ooh. Now Lesnar. Now taking control.
Nice by Lesnar, and
every time.
What's this?
It's The Rock countered into a DDT. He's gonna cover.
One, two. Oh. It's been the thing about this match. Brock has been able to find counters for Brock, and, well, Lesnar hasn't been really able to fully take control of this match yet.
And I've been noticing every time The Rock tries to come back and, ooh, every time The Rock tries to come back in this match, he'll get a couple moves out, but then Brock Lesnar would just reverse it.
Lesnar is, ooh, and there's another suplex by Lesnar. Just like you said, Brock comes at him and, well, Brock's finding a way to take down The Rock.
Now The Rock coming back. No, like I said, every time The Rock comes back.
Belly to belly, very nice.
And here's a cover. That has to be it for The Rock. One, two.
No. Close, but no cigar. The Rock starting to fight.
And ooh, Samoa drop. This could be the advantage now. Wait a minute.
Comes the shittiest performed sharpshooter ever.
It's locked in.
And The Rock, he's locked. He's got it, like you said, he's got it locked in, but he needs to pull. Locks Brock.
Brock
powering out. And, ooh, kick to the gut and
back. Brock
Lesnar of his own.
Here's a cover. One. When? No. Every time The Rock, like I keep on saying, ooh! Maybe The Rock now, changing momentum.
Rock, ooh.
But no!
Another suplex by Brock Lesnar. Holy crap. Brock cannot really get ahead in this match.
Wait a minute, F5?
Oh,
no!
Ooh! He tried to F5 him a little too early, I think. And. No.
And all right to the eyes. Lesnar to Rock.
The kick. But.
Rock just. Wait a minute. Rock bottom.
Oh. Lesnar is able to counter the Rock bottom.
Ooh.
Nice. Punch slash close.
Oh, wait a minute. Here it comes.
Five. F5.
F5. There it is.
Drag
I think that's going to be it.
That's going to be all she wrote, but one, two, three, and Brock is able to once again beat The Rock.
Brock Lesnar, The Rock, like, I've been noticing him coming back in the match, but Brock Lesnar was a counter every 10 seconds.
I asphyxiated number, but anyways... Like you said, Brock, like, every time The Rock really got something going, Brock was able to just take control, and then we saw the F5 with all she wrote. Lesnar tried to go for an F5 once, Brock was able to counteract, then The Rock went for a Rock bottom, but Lesnar said no and was able to hit an F5 for the win.
And now Brock Lesnar gaining some momentum. Heading into the Royal Rumble and future episodes of Raw.
Nice win by Brock, and now he's got his mind off of Randy Orton and much more on the site of the Royal Rumble. It is Batista who is getting a title shot at the WEDF Championship.
One thing Grayson brought up is Kofi Kingston has had the number of Batista every time they've met. Batista says it's disrespectful to see a man like Kofi Kingston stature as WEDF Champion. He says it's a tough guy's business. Up next, oh my, this is a rematch from episode 39. A song called The Rattlesnake Meets a Viper. Up next.
These two are both coming off of wins from Survivor Series.
I cannot wait for this match. The Rattlesnake versus the Viper.
Oh my.
And like you said, Drew, both men coming off a win from Survivor Series.
They both need to use that momentum. Punk, Stone Cold beating CM Punk and Randy Orton beating Brock Lesnar. Both those men, CM Punk and Brock Lesnar, have already picked up wins tonight.
Stone Cold, you know, he's had three past Royal Rumble victories on August 18th. Will he win a fourth Rumble match? No one has ever won four Royal Rumbles in WWE/WEDF history. Now, that'd be huge for Stone Cold. He's been screwed over the WEDF Championship ever since Survivor Series last year. After he won an Elimination Chamber to retain, but Abyss came out and won a table match orchestrated by Vince McMahon. And here comes Randy Orton. This is a rematch from episode 39. Last time these two met in a one-on-one match, they also met in a triple threat involving John Cena, which John Cena won last year to earn a number one contenders match against then-champion Abyss. Stone Cold found a way in that match, and Abyss was unable to compete thanks to Kane and Undertaker returning last year. But anyway, back to matters on this match. This is a huge match. The Stone Cold Stunner versus the RKO. Who's going to give?
Honestly, it's like the Stone Cold Stunner on its own is amazing, but it really doesn't come out of nowhere as much as the RKO. The RKO can practically counter anything. The Stunner it's a little more, I guess, complicated of moves, so to say.
No, like you said, RKO can counter under anything. It can hit at any time, but same thing goes for the Stunner. Here we go. Here we go.
These two are squaring up right now and locking up.
Orton
off the those bitches uppercut.
And, ooh, forearm to the face. Now Austin.
Austin. Ooh, very nice punches by Austin.
Texas Rattle saying that brawl. These two are huge brawlers, so this is really going to be a slugfest. It's gonna be like a barroom brawl. Randy Orton weapons Austin now.
Shot kick by Orton.
Think about this match. The winner of this match will face Brock Lesnar next time on Raw.
Wow, so if Randy Orton wins, we're tactically seeing another repeat of Survivor Series.
But if Austin wins, we get to see Stone Cold versus Brock Lesnar for the first time ever.
Which I wouldn't mind seeing, because I believe personally Lesnar versus Orton, that's old. That should just be gone. We should have something new, like you said, Austin versus Brock Lesnar for the first time ever.
Yeah, I don't concur. I don't know if there's any time it's ever happened before.
And Orton.
Austin get outside the ring.
Ooh. Uppercut. European uppercut.
Austin ran into the barricade.
Gonna send Austin's face first right onto that barricade.
And ooh, right to the steel post.
Ooh.
That's in the head. Randy Orton.
Oh, Stone Cold.
And oh!
Stone Cold.
What a clothesline.
Stone Cold saying no way.
Going back, that's. I think he wants to give Orton a little payback.
Little deja vu, and all.
And Orton to the ring.
No, Stone Cold coming in. Wait, Orton catches Stone Cold.
Oh no,
Orton.
DDT.
Orton.
Orton a knee drop.
Knee drop by Orton.
Oh, I thought he was about ready to go for the punt already.
Looks like it was too. Looks like Orton was trying to stalk Stone Cold.
Oh, starting to use those European uppercuts like it's his business. Austin. And Austin, another back body drop.
So far this match is not disappointed. This has been what we've expected. It's been a brawl all over the arena. On the outside, the inside. Something a mud hole.
God.
walking it dry.
That's also vintage Austin right there.
Elbows.
Not one to mess with.
Wharton getting his hand on the rope. Ooh. His double icon right there. Wharton countering. No!
Ooh. Austin with the counter of his own. A kick to the gut. And so what's Austin going to do? No. Wharton's starting to get warmed up here. And
Wharton now.
No! Oh! Oh. No!
No! What a counter by Austin.
Suplex.
This could be it.
Recover. One and two, and Wharton kicks out.
Wharton getting the shoulder up. Wharton counters. And no! Oh my god!
He just picked him up. Wharton was going for a clothesline. Now look at Stone Cold going for a pop. Right, Wharton!
Oh no!
Arm drag. Orton's doing some flexibility there.
Was able to roll out of that.
Fired up now.
RK, no!
RKO!
RK, no!
And Stone Cold, no!
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 Who's gonna give in this match?
Ooh, close line.
We both may counter each other's finishing moves. What's gonna give?
And ooh. Hit to the face, pointing off the ropes, and ooh! Austin running right into a clothesline.
Wharton getting fired up now. And another clothesline. Now Wharton looking for it. No. Stone Cold from behind. What's Stone Cold going for? No. Wharton ducks.
That's power slam. Wharton. Here goes for a cover.
One. Two.
No. Close, but no cigar.
Wharton countered neckbreaker.
Very nice neckbreaker by Andy Wharton.
And Wharton getting fired up. Wharton now looking to stalk Austin. Can he hit the RKO this time?
Wharton getting fired up. This could be the end. RKO! No!
Stalk going over this. No!
No!
Again! Now Wharton! Oh, that's a cool neckbreaker. Now we got a cover. Will this be it for Stone Cold? One, two, and oh! Stone Cold kicks out.
And oh, missed drop kick. Austin taking advantage of that.
Oh, who's going to give in this match? What's going to give these competitors? Stone Cold, no, again!
Andy Wharton.
A scoop slam. The Viper. Now, Wharton, this is classic Wharton, nitpicking every part of the body. Everything.
Stone Cold.
Austin.
I think Austin got busted. Yes, he did, and he's going for a cover. One.
Two. Stone Cold kicks out again. Busted up and all, and everything.
And no, again!
What a match we're having.
What ducks for Stone Cold. Back elbow. What's Stone Cold going for now? Oh wait, Stone Cold! Here we go, the Lutheran press!
Vintage Stone Cold there.
Austin, here's Vintage, also Stone Cold right there. Driving the elbow. Here's the cover.
One.
Two.
Wharton kicks out.
This is getting close.
Oh, Wharton ducks.
Wharton.
For RKO with his double.
RKO. I countered again. Wait a minute, Austin. Stunner.
Stunner.
The fourth
stunner was hit.
Arm. And Stone Cold, he's going to do this.
Stone Cold's going to
do it. One. Two. And Stone Cold with a huge victory. Over Randy Wharton.
Stone Cold will face Brock Lesnar next week.
That match is going to be huge.
Both men.
And Don't mention this as champion at all. Brock Lesnar, I think he's got me a little bit nervous. Because he's got to get meet Stone Cold for the first time ever. I mean, Brock Lesnar was going to face Stone Cold, I heard, in 2002, but Austin walked out. Austin will get his chance to face Brock Lesnar next time on Raw for the first time ever, though. What a win for Stone Cold after that. Grueling victory after Stone Cold got busted open. He's going to need some band-aids after this. Some band-aids to go up.
I don't think Stone Cold gives a damn.
Could have been SOB see the Rattlesnake pick up a win here tonight.
Maybe Brock Lesnar had to be watching this match.
And Brock Lesnar was recovering from the match against The Rock. Anyway, here's CM Punk, who won earlier tonight, and he's at Todd Grisham. What you got to say?
I would agree with CM Punk. He is the best in the business today.
Since he's no ripoff, he's just CM Punk, the best in the world. He says he's going to throw everyone over the top rope to win that Royal Rumble on August 18th. But next, WEDF Championship, Kofi Kingston to take out Batista. Well, this match changed the landscape of the Royal Rumble main event for the Raw side. We're going to find out next.
We already have one of our competitors set for that match, The Miz, but right now we're going to find out who's going to be walking into the Rumble with the title.
Batista, the man that gets in, getting another shot at the WEDF title.
I mean, he was the interim champion and almost had that WEDF championship won. And then Kofi Kingston but hit The Rock on the outside with a throw on Paradise, and that's all she said, wrote, and Batista is visibly upset about that. Kofi's reign as WEDF champion may be in jeopardy here tonight against a vicious animal who's ready to unleash himself.
Indeed, and there's not a bunch of other people in this match. They're not three of the men that Kofi can just go out and tend at him and the animal.
Here comes Kofi Kingston, current WEDF champion.
How long will he be WEDF champion after this, after tonight? Will he be able to win?
You see here, Kofi Kingston, The Miz, this could change. If Batista wins, it'll be Batista instead of Kofi challenging for the WEDF Championship. We're going to find out right now who is going to the Royal Rumble.
I could not wait for this match. Miz has to be watching in on this match right now.
Here we go, the referee raising the gold as this match is about to be underway.
We'll be able to pull off a win here tonight.
Batista's ready. Kofi's ready. Here we go. Batista, the power of the animal. I mean, he's really never been able to beat Kofi Kingston before. Will tonight be the night?
I don't know. We've seen countless times that Kofi, he's just found a way to pull out a win. And
I mean, Batista feels like Kofi's been a joke to this business. He doesn't feel Kofi's worthy of being WEDF champion.
Well, it's time for Batista to prove that here. He can't hide behind his words. He needs to prove it. Kofi with the kick there.
Kofi off the ropes.
Oh! God, what a clothesline. The power of the animal is something of awe.
The animal is unleashed out of his cage here tonight. And Kofi's in big trouble now. There's a shoulder thrust in the corner.
Now Batista taking control.
And, oh! Very smart by Kofi.
And Batista rolling to the outside. Taking a timeout and oh! Why, that makes a wise strategy by Batista.
he's gonna do.
Don't miss him that boot. Kofi dropkick.
Oof, but it barely affects Batista.
Dude, that just made Batista mad. Now Kofi.
Kofi gonna do. They have to watch for the count. They're up to five already.
Kofi Kingston.
Oh.
Looking to maybe take a page out of Batista's playbook. Usually we see Batista maybe doing going for this. Or the bang his head on the steel steps.
Batista, you need a Kofi in the ring or something. You can't win out here.
That's right, he can't. That would be a huge, embarrassing loss if Batista were to lose that way.
And oh!
That'd be shades of what happened to Batista versus Edge at Night of Champions in 2007. Batista had that match won, but he lost by countout.
That's a good point there.
Ooh. Oh, Kofi. Closer to something there, but Batista counters. Batista, what's this?
Oh!
Oh! Ooh. Big kick to the face. That has to be it. We have a new W. Oh!
Not even a one count.
The more Kofi kicks out, the more frustrated Batista is. Batista can't let his first choice and get the mayor of him, otherwise Kofi Kingston's gonna find a way to hit that trouble in paradise out of nowhere and get that victory.
Batista, he really needs to just focus his frustration and his strength and be able to...
Batista!
Wait a minute, Kofi.
Kofi gonna...
And Kofi!
Very nice by Kofi!
That was beautiful.
And Batista going into the steel steps, and this is Kofi's opening. Oh!
Ooh.
Kofi Kingston just giving it at all. He doesn't want to lose this WEDF Championship. And Kofi now. Oh!
Oh!
That was not smart by Kofi.
Huge mistake. Batista met Kofi in midair. Now Batista. Oh, this is not good.
But,
oh! Oh. Right on the steel steps!
How did Kofi Kingston get up from that? I don't know.
Back would be broken.
Fucking Kofi's back already.
Kofi, I guess, just momentum helped him up.
Now, Batista.
Oh,
kick to the leg. Maybe some strategy Kofi Kingston might need to take. Oh!
Take the legs of Batista, much of this power game is rather useless.
Batista now in control. Oh, what a clue.
Oh, God.
Vicious. This could be it for Kofi, too.
And oh, Kofi. Oh, very, very close. Much more can Kofi do here?
Oh, Batista shoving Kofi away. And again. Another close one. Batista just stalking his prey now. They're shoving that knee right in the face of Kofi Kingston.
What can Kofi do to get out of this predicament?
Wait, Batista, what's this? And suplex, I guess.
We got a butterfly suplex. Now Batista just. Oh, Kofi kick to the gut.
Black hole.
Catches him.
Has to be it for Kofi. One,
two.
Wow,
I thought that was gonna be all she wrote, but I guess not.
Kofi trying to fight back now. He's hurting though. Batista's got Kofi right where he wants him though. Kofi's championship reign, I think, is in jeopardy.
That's neckbreaker by Kofi.
That could be the opening Kofi needs as a drop kick. Now,
and Kofi.
Batista just overpowering Kofi again. But on Kofi, got the knees up.
Come on, Kofi. You can do this.
Kofi trying to open the legs, but Batista again countering.
God.
It seems like every time Kofi tries to get momentum, Batista just finds a way to turn the tide before Kofi can get any type of momentum. and again the sort of thrust.
Ooh, just working on the back, the bad back of Kofi. As we did see earlier, his back landed on the steel steps.
Ooh. How much more can Kofi really take? He's just getting the living hell beat.
Champion, two!
Yeah, oh. Kofi! Batista, he might have doubt in his mind. Can he beat Kofi Kingston? I don't think he can.
I think he's...
I think it was a ref! Batista not happy!
And
wait a minute! Oh, that's gonna cost Batista, though!
Here it comes!
No!
What a counter!
Hurricane Rana and a cover! No! Rope break.
But, I mean, Kofi might have Batista's number. I don't think Batista can beat Kofi. He's done everything he can. But do you think Batista can win?
I don't know. Batista is... His frustration is going to get to him, and it's going to cost him this match if he can't keep focused.
We went for that Batista bomb, but Kofi managed to counter. Man, a spear!
Ooh, spear! That there might be what he is. One, two, no!
And Kofi Kingston kicked out.
Kofi is just...
Look at Batista, he's taking his first... Oh, Batista, you better not... You're going to risk disqualification here. It's a
Kofi! Costed Batista by a lot!
And now Kofi now with the momentum. Batista's anger might have cost him this match! Right to left! Batista! Kofi keeps feeling it!
Better hope the Miz is watching this match!
Miz, I think he likes what he's seeing, how badly Kofi is hurting, but I don't know, Batista can't beat Kofi, so...
And a monkey foot!
And Kofi, he's feeling it for the first time in this match, I think. Kofi's got the momentum. Can he continue?
No! It's Batista. No, Kofi!
He's fighting back.
Kofi, look at him, cross body!
Cross body, very nice by Kofi Kingston.
Now he's getting all fired up again.
Time for boom, boom.
No!
Oh. Right to the eyes. Typical of Batista.
Wait a minute. Batista.
Lift him up. This is going to be shades of Goldberg.
Yeah, camera, wait, Kofi, roll up!
Roll up!
Roll up!
Find a count, no! Count, one!
Two!
Wow, so close.
I mean, I've never seen that happen before, and Kofi actually rolled him over.
Back. Thank you. Heel kick by Kofi. Kofi setting up here.
What a main event this is. And now, Kofi. Elevation and left. Kofi Kingston went with that springboard drop kick.
Kofi getting all fired up again. Here it comes, Drew.
Boom! Boom!
Boom drop. And Kofi going for a cover, not wasting any time. One,
two. Batista kicks out. What does Kofi got to do now?
Got to hit that at SOS or Trouble in Paradise.
Well, can he?
And oh, wait.
Wait a minute. Oh, wait a minute.
Yeah, roll up. Another roll up.
What? One.
No! One! No! Oh.
Wow.
Kofi kicking out.
Batista got caught! Wait!
Wait!
What's this?
Kofi gets the top of paradise! Out of nowhere! Kofi gets the bottom!
Hit
the top of paradise! One!
Two! Three!
Kofi is still the champion! What a grueling match! This is for a main event of Raw!
Now Kofi meets The Miz at the Royal Rumble.
Kofi didn't make it two in a row, but this time win the WEDF Championship. Look at Kofi, he went for that. He counted that Batista bomb into a Hurricane Rana. And then Batista just got so upset. They might have gotten the better of him.
Batista still, he can't beat Kofi, and it stays true tonight. Don't know what Batista can do about Kofi Kingston anymore. Kofi's moving on to the Royal Rumble to face The Miz. Batista has to go back to the drawing board.
Well, Batista will probably be a part of the Rumble. Who knows, maybe he'll win it. If Kofi's champion, maybe that'll lead to a WrestleMania match. Never know. But what a win here for Kofi Kingston. Just defying the odds again. But will odds catch up to him as Miz, he's got a huge target. A very hungry Miz, who has won last year against the Royal Rumble against Kofi Kingston. Win the Intercontinental Championship. Will Miz win the WEDF Championship from him? And Miz!
The Miz!
Oh,
the Miz!
Is
oh!
Oh!
The Miz.
Speaking of the Miz.
Hey Miz, what's up?
Miz, getting a little close in here. I don't think Miz liked it when Kofi is focused off of him and took it on Batista. And
make it quick.
Hey, shit on the chair!
Oh my god.
Sending a message to Kofi Kingston.
Will the Miz do this and win the WEDF Championship at the Royal Rumble? I believe they should make this match a no disqualification match, because this feud is going to boil over the next few weeks. It's going to boil big time.
I'm the Miz.
The Miz win the Royal Rumble main event and win the WEDF Championship. This is Frank Dog, Steven and Drew. We will see you later.